But that is, I mean,
it is
a serious issue.
It is a serious. We might be laughing about it, but trust me, it is a serious issue. Yes,
in this country,
it is.
So that stems from what, would you say, in your opinion, misdiagnosis? Does it stem from poor training of doctors? Does it stem from just negligence?
It's mixture of negligence and poor training. But I don't know. You know, medicine, I also think it's a passion.
Mm-hmm.
There you'd have a passion for designing, or you want it to be perfect.
Yes.
And I think because we have very few numbers of doctors and these specialists, it's like they've seen so much cases, so...
And they're not passionate enough.
Yes,
they're
like, kuna line ngine na ngoja. And you see, it's more commercialized. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry to say medicine in Kenya is really business. Those who are getting very best, very good services have money. They have medical covers.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, for patients who have complicated or inborn problems, which insurance company would want to cover you? Utatumia 10 million kwa hospitali na umetoa miezi tatu. Most of them wouldn't even want
that's
to.
That's the rationale.
They're like, yes, they're like, oops, here yako.
Let's keep away from it.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. But if the government would come out and say, these complicated cases, let's just handle them. I don't see the reason why a child should be kept because he or she needs heart surgery to save his life.
Mm-hmm.
Una mtoto ameextend, you anafikisha 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of the day, anasuffer from pressure. Kidneys zina fail. At the end of the day, anakufa. And maybe mtoto angekuwa president. I'm a minister. No, that's very serious.
Mm.
I believe everybody is born for a reason, not to die. Yeah. Yeah, we are born to be 100 plus years.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, 70. Ishi ingine ambia Mungu asante.
Mm-hmm.
But at least, I believe if you are called to be a doctor, God knows why he gave you that knowledge. Use it properly. Wachana na mambo ya pesa. Actually, you do that favor and ask him for a car, he'll give you that expensive car you want.
Yes.
Instead of, let's not commercialize really medical.
And commercialize because, lives.
Because, yes, because not so many people come up from well-up family. Not so many people can afford insurance. Most of them have to pay from their pockets. And believe you me, wale wagonjwa zaidi ya wananga kitu kwa mfuko. And that's where money is. That's where real issues are.
That's where real problems are.
Yes, and that's where we can really get training.
Because
every time we let them go there, yeah, they lose us. They gain. Tunawapea pesa. Na wana perfect kazi yao ya kukata watu. Kuoperate. Yes.
And nothing, I mean, no benefit comes to
no
us.
No benefit really comes. Okay, that person lives longer. At least ametolewa shida.
Yes, but the problems continue to exist.
Yes, kesho kuna mwingine atazaliwa na the same case. What happens?
Yeah. All right. So I think this has been a very interesting discussion. And the sad thing is that all we can do is talk about it, you know. So these are things that will have to be dealt with slowly, I guess, over time.
The government wants that assistant, I can look them up.
You can be consulted.
They can
Actually, you have a lot of data.
I have a lot of data. I even know some hospitals are willing to train.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that we don't know the kind of approach we can use. Exactly.
Mm-hmm. So it's people like you with the links.
Yes, come, I hook you up. Talk to me, I'll hook you up.
All right.
Yes.
Thank you very much. I hope we can have you again and continue. These are not issues that we can discuss once or twice or even three times.
No problem.
Huge issues that require a lot of time.
Yeah.
But all the same, we are grateful for your time.
Thank you so much for hosting me.
All right.
Really grateful.
You have been watching The Experts Say. We've been talking to Mary Waigwa, who's a medical researcher, and I hope you've learned a thing or two about the work that she does. I have been your host, Marianne Waisha. Do have yourself a splendid time.